John, can you cook this?
Trans freedom fighters, as well as to unite the cannabis community in New Jersey. We will now pass the community torch to the next state, which is Philly, coming up over in the state house. To continue the East Coast Unity Cipher, we will keep the torch of activism lit until the whole East Coast sees an end to cannabis prohibition.
Legalization bills, but we hold these events so that we can meet like-minded people, we can share. Where's the giant joy torch at? So we created a campaign to create more awareness about all the people doing grassroots activism on the ground on the East Coast states, because much of the news and information about cannabis legalization is about West Coast states and all the money they're making. And we kind of feel left out over here on the East Coast because people are still getting arrested. 25,000 people in the state of New Jersey got arrested last year for cannabis. And that actually went up from 20,000. So this joint torch was created in Baltimore by our friend Kevin Cranford of Maryland Normal. And that's right, give it up for Kevin for making this nice science See, stoners are productive. And we sent it to Portland, Maine. And it went from Portland, Maine to New Hampshire to Vermont to Boston, Massachusetts to Connecticut. We were in New York City yesterday with it. Give it up for your Trenton local, Phil Charles.
Thank you, everybody. You know what I mean? I'm gonna keep it real.
But throughout the years, like, it went from me being arrested to like meeting other people and realizing like it could really help and change people's lives. So it transpired from me to like the masses that are out here and the ones that can't even come, you know. So my message to you guys is, no matter what the reason is for you to get like more involved in the marijuana movement, whether it's being arrested, one of your friends or family has cancer or is sick or ailing, or you just want to know more, you want to change the laws for the better, just use that as your reason to get more involved. If you want to find out more information, you can always come down to the New Jersey Weed Man's Joint. We have tons of things happening down there all the time. We got a great crowd, and we love to educate people there. So, something was 420 on 420. So, if you ain't got them, roll them. And before I go, can't forget, we don't have our L Captain with us today, New Jersey Weed Man. So, once again, I want to say free the weed, man.
Free the weed, man! Free the weed, man!
Free the weed, man. You know what I mean? And let's smoke up and enjoy this 420.
And as we would say, fuck the law! Our next speaker is Joanne Zito. And I'm
wearing kind of many hats today, as Vanessa said, here for East Coast Cannabis Coalition.
During a congressional hearing last year, which I watched live on C-SPAN, dealing with the heroin epidemic in the U.S., I discovered these facts. It shocked me. The gateway drug to heroin is Percocet, Vicodin, pain pills, not marijuana. Cannabis.
Hundreds of thousands of dollars putting these innocent people away for a plant, and we're not going to stand for it anymore. We're tired of these laws. Mandatory minimum sentences are bullshit, and they're designed to make money for prisons and pharmaceutical companies. It's important to include the voices of the people behind bars, because we have hundreds of thousands of people in the United States. We have 25% of the world's prison population. That is really ridiculous. You need to keep telling people that. They don't realize that we have most of the world's prisoners, you know, more than any other developed country. And most of those people are incarcerated for nonviolent drug offenses, and it's wrong. So our next speaker is another medical cannabis patient. He is the producer and host of the Sativa Cross podcast.
Hey everybody, happy 420. My name's Lefty Grimes. I with sativacross.com. I got my medical marijuana card a couple of years ago after being on opiates for 10 years. I was on 90 milligrams of roxycodone every 3 hours. And it was a lot of misery in my life. So I got my medical marijuana card, and I got a camera, and we started going to police stations, smoking weed at police stations. Woo! With Chuck Kwiatkowski and Wayne and all these crazy guys. A lot of you out there have been with us. And the reason why we do this, people say, well, Lefty, don't poke the bear. You're going to get in trouble. Don't do that. Well, you know what? They're coming after you anyway. They're going to come after you whether you have a card or not. You might as well fight back and play offense. We have a chance to play offense now, and that's what we're doing in New Jersey. We can do in New Jersey what nobody else can do around the country is smoke weed at police stations. Nobody else in the country can smoke weed at police stations. Can you believe that? The one good thing about our law, one good thing, smoking weed at friggin' police stations, really? They let kids die, but we can smoke weed at police stations. Okay. Doesn't make sense. But the reason why we do this is because patients are being arrested. My friends,
of all the patients that are dying, like Sabina Rose, like little Gracie in Pennsylvania, like Marie in Pennsylvania, like all the people that are going to die waiting for their cannabis in Pennsylvania. There's still people waiting. There's still people dying. And it's no joke. And we end each show with a moment of silence, and something is written in stone down the street here at the memorial. And we never knew that. And it's called the Ode of Remembrance, written in World War I. And it goes like this. They shall grow not old, as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun, and in the morning, we will remember them. We will remember them. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. It's a holiday. I hope you all enjoy yourselves today. But it's, you know, 420. We need to make 420 every day, all right? Not just here, not just coming out and smoking in public and trying to tell people this is immoral, which of course I'm sure we all agree it absolutely is. Cannabis prohibition is immoral.
Yes.
And we all agree on things that everybody here can be doing to make the movement move a little further, okay? This is great. This is a great start. Everybody can do a little bit. Some can do more than others. You can write letters to the editor of your local newspaper. You can write an email to your representatives. You can run for office. That's what got me involved with the Libertarian Party. I was a cannabis reform activist for 7 years, and I started to realize that this one issue affects a whole lot of other issues. People talk about mass incarceration. We talk about crony capitalism, income inequality. There's tons of issues, health issues. All can be solved by legalizing cannabis. And so this one issue, if you care about this, be careful. It's a gateway. You might become active in government. Then you'd be really useless. It's a gateway to caring about other people and to caring about other issues. I found the Libertarian Party because, they've been involved in supporting cannabis legalization since the 70s when Nixon declared the war on drugs. And through the 80s, through the Just Say No program, they've been there all along saying, no, this is not right. Prohibition is immoral. It took 12 years to get it straight with alcohol, but here we are begging the government to legalize cannabis after 75 years. It's been too long, wouldn't you agree?
Yay!
So I'm here today to ask you all, check out the Libertarian Party, okay? Because the Republicans and Democrats have had their time. Obama inhaled a lot. And nobody here thinks that his life would have been any better had he been thrown in prison. He might not have been president, you know? Governor Christie claims that he's pro-life before the life is born and after they're born. But not if you smoke cannabis. If you smoke cannabis, you're going to have to wait. And we hope you make it until the wait is over. It's not acceptable. We're not taking it anymore. And so I'm upping my game, and I'd like you all to do the same.
This is what happened. I was on Facebook and I kept seeing Free New Jersey Weed Man. So I'm like, wait, hold up. I just saw him the other day. He said, Trinity, are you ready for 420? I said, hell yeah, I got something for their ass because I don't understand why they bothering us. So the next thing I know, it says, Free New Jersey Weed Man. I said, he locked up. Why? How the fuck he?
Sorry.
No, yeah, fuck that. How he get locked up for calming me down? Can you believe he calmed me down? So basically what I want to say is that everybody has a story. Everybody has a situation. And they try to tell me when I was on drugs, not marijuana, when I was on drugs, use your imagination, to stay away from the people, the places, and the things. So I said, well, how do I stay away from myself? I am the people, the places, and the things. All right, so this is what happened. I was going to shout out to Greater Trenton for medication to keep my anxiety, my depression, and my post-traumatic stress disorder and everything that's wrong with me by this medication that makes me want to go kill myself and make me want to do other things wrong. And then the weed man was standing right there, and he was like this tall. I said, I need to be your friend. I said, don't worry about these colors, this red, green, and gold I got on, because I had this before you got here, but I need to be your friend. He said, well, you know what? I need friends. I said, all right, so every day I was there. I was a landmark, going there, make a left on Trinity. I was there. Now, it hurts me. This activism and all this, I'm just pro just pro get better. Like, I mean, what, to me, like, weed ain't never make me sell myself. Weed ain't never make me steal nobody TV. Weed ain't make me steal, do, y'all know what you do. Y'all know what the hell you can do. Cause I know what I've done, and everybody got a story. So all I'm saying that to say, I don't appreciate them coming up in the Kumas of the sanctuary and just make him follow all his paperwork, do everything that he's supposed to do, and then you just wanna walk up in there and tell me to leave from being happy. Why you mad? You mad cause nobody fighting? Right. You mad ain't nobody getting shot?
Right.
You know what we doing? We getting better, so I'm just doing something right for myself.
Right.
I don't know what else to say after that, but all y'all know, smoke till you choke, goddammit.
So give it up for Terry from Anonymous New Jersey, also known as Barack Oganja from Anonymous Hemp Sector.
Yeah, Barack!
Can you guys hear me? Okay. So my name is Terry Harris. The reason why I am famous for Anonymous Hemp Sector is because when I reached out to a member, I basically told him, hey, you know what, there's a school for medical marijuana, and he looked at me and said, you know what, you don't deserve to be a member, you deserve to be a distinguished member. And ever since then, I've just been telling people, hey, there's a school for medical marijuana, where you can either build your own company, or you can join the $42 billion a year industry already established. There's jobs, Christy, in the medical marijuana industry. You want them here in Jersey. There's a school, just so you know. Now, also, one thing I also wanted to, I wouldn't be here today if it wasn't for the Weed Man. He's been my hero. I started everything in his name, and the Joint Boys have only been a motivation to me. One of the things that I also wanted to tell everybody is that I actually will be leaving soon, unfortunately, to go to D.C. and run my own dispensary that an investor finally wants to invest in. I'm out of here, but I couldn't leave Jersey unless I had it in secure hands, and I chosen one member of the Joint Boys. I would like to y'all to put your hands together for Ghost.
Anonymous!
Anonymous, New Jersey.
Yeah.
Mask up. You got something to say to the people? No.
They know.
They already know.
They know.
So yeah, if you wanted to know more about the school, information about Anonymous, Ghost has it. Coming down to the Joint. Oh, and one last thing. What was it? Oh, free the fucking weed, man.
So I've been following CMMNJ for many years, and Weed Man, and Lefty, and everybody, and my head was still in the game, but my body wasn't. So I decided to end it. I went off all my narcotics, all the antisocial, psycho, whatever kind of medications I was on, and I went off cold turkey, and I am now proud to say I am 9 months, no narcotics at all. I take cannabis, and I have to say thank you to Lefty and everybody in the movement have been so supportive for me, and it's just a huge thing that's opened in my life. And once I went off it, the first thing I did was come to a CMMNJ and Sativa Cross podcast here at the State House. That was my first thing I did. I didn't know anybody, but I knew them. So I figured I have to give back. That's what we all have to do. If you want to change stuff, you can't complain if you're not in the game. You have to be here. We need people. We need bodies. We need to be strong in numbers and show everyone that we are serious. This is a serious thing. I mean, I'm 46 years old. I can't believe I just told you that. I lost my whole 30s and half my 40s. I was in freaking bed. I lost all that time. Well, I want it back, and I am getting it back. I am getting it back, and we need to legalize and help other people. There's other people out there that need it.
Democracy Spring, and he's gonna tell you a little bit about their incredible march from Philly to Washington, D.C., and the hundreds of people that just got arrested last week who are protesting money in politics. So give it up for Kyle Moore.
Hey guys, as Vanessa said, my name's Kyle Moore and I'm an organizer for the East Coast Cannabis Coalition. And I just got back from marching 140 miles from Philadelphia to DC.
Good shit, man.
In this march, I represented the East Coast Cannabis Coalition because this group marched to get money out of politics.
Yes.
And that affects us in the marijuana movement because pharmaceutical companies and private prisons are the ones that lobby for prohibition. So I marched with them for 140 miles and arrived in DC on April 10th. And on April 11th, we knew hundreds of us were going to be arrested. So on the night of April 10th, right before getting arrested the next day in front of the Capitol building, 500 people filled the room, all to get training to get arrested the next day. We overpacked the room so people could break the law, but not just break the law, to fix the law. Because money out of politics is necessary for us to legalize marijuana. And I just want to say, before 420, that I'm proud to be standing with hundreds of people again, all ready for civil disobedience to not just break the law, but to fix the law.
Yeah.
And if you haven't heard about these arrests, over 1,200 were arrested in 1 week. And there was a media blackout on this. And the only New Jersey paper to write about this was the Trentonian. Yes. And the person writing for the Trentonian?
Weedman.
NJ Weedman.
Weedman!
So since he can't be here today, we need to change the law, we need to fix the law, and we need to say, fuck the law, smoke it anyway. Thank you.
All right, I want to thank you all for coming down here, for being brave. It's not easy to stand up against injustice. So thank you for coming out here, standing with us in solidarity, and for educating yourself. We hope after this you will spread the word, you will let people know what happened here, you'll share your pictures, you'll tell your story, and you will continue to fight against the drug war and continue to fight for legalization. Let's cross the street and celebrate 420.
Yeah.
And free the New Jersey weed man.
Fight the herb, me can't stand it. Me a sow the seed, Babylon can't come step on it. Me a mix the weed with all the Grey Goose and tonic. Youth man, no stop all the chronic. Every day, me roll the weed up. Take a few strands and me mix a couple breed up. Can't stand it when some boy go the seed up. Me no do that, he get cheaped up. Me say herb, herb, what we a prefer. Them a juggle it on every street curb. And the youth a say weed is life. Reality.
Smoke the weed every day. Don't smoke the seeds.